Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I'm going to teach you how to mix 7 weird noises with your electric guitar. I'm also going to throw in a couple of honourable mentions at the end. Now, some of these sounds are practical. You can use them in applications like bands have for years. Some of them are a bit more impractical and just there to have a bit of fun with. These are also great for the guitarists out there, like myself, that isn't a super shredder. Like, can't do crazy all the Buckethead stuff and Paul Gilbert stuff. I've been in bands where the lead guitar player has played so much crazy stuff and blew everyone's minds. If I make a funny noise, or something that people go, what the hell is he doing? That turns way more heads than someone doing loads of sweet picking. This video actually came about because we uploaded a 5 best weird guitar noises on TikTok. PMT House of Rock on TikTok, give us a cheeky wee follow over there. And it went viral. It blew up and everybody loved it. Everyone's like, what the hell is this weirdo doing with that guitar? And how does it sound so crackers, but also amazing at the same time? So I thought I would do a full length video explaining these weird noises, the origins and how to actually do them in a bit more detail, not condensed down into 60 seconds for you guys to enjoy and annoy your friends and family and annoy your neighbors, your fans and everyone in between. And with that, if you want to expand on anything I talk about in this video or even add in your own quirky weird guitar noise, please comment down below and share the love. Tiny little disclaimer, a lot of these sounds do require a tremolo, either a double locking Floyd Rose if you want to stay in tune, or like a Strat style tremolo. It will totally work, it just might not stay in tune as well as a Floyd Rose. So sorry for the non-trem guys out there, but these are crackers to begin with. And you can get much weirder sounds out of a guitar with a Floyd Rose. So, without further ado, let's get started. The first noise is the PAC-MAN noise. I saw Herman Lee do this years ago on YouTube, and it's amazing. Herman Lee is a pioneer of crackers guitar noises, the guitar singer from Dragon Force. And it's very simple. To make a guitar sound like Pac-Man, just get a piece of metal, like a slide or your tremolo arm, which is what Herman uses and I'm using as well, and just rub it back and forth on the strings. Crackers, is that? That's amazing. And I've just realized, like, this is my job, and there's people next door going, what's he doing? Pac-Man. So this is the bridge pickup is engaged. If you go past the bridge pickup, it's not really going to work. You've got to be towards the neck, so to get it to pick up. So that's Pac-Man. If you want to sound like a Star Wars droid, go back and forth. It's a bit R2-D2-y, or you can combine them. And just sound as ridiculous as the name suggests. So that's Pac-Man. Next up we have the horse noise. There's the noise of a horse whinnying, made famous by, probably invented by Mr. Edward Van Halen back in the day, one of my all-time guitar heroes. And a lot of people said on TikTok, Herman Lee invented that or whatever. No, this is Eddie Van Halen. Eddie Van Halen and Steve Vai were pioneers before Herman Lee started doing all this, but he's just kind of took them to the next level. But anyways, the horse noise. Get yourself a pinch harmonic. And pinch on the 3rd or 2nd fret of the G string. And bend up. And when you're at the top, have some fun with that Floyd Rose system. To make it sound like a horse, wouldn't you? My neighbors hate me. Actually, there's officers upstairs. Got computers going, what the hell's happening downstairs? So that's how to make your guitar sound like a horse. At number 3, this is a weird sound where you don't need a Floyd Rose or a tremolo. It's like a harmonic run, let's say. And I do this in so many PMTVUK videos. I do it live at the end of songs all the time, and it blows way more minds in the crowd than someone shredding away. And it's simply, do natural harmonics. Kind of ones you use to stay in tune or to dive bomb with. Do it on the low string, the low E string, and go back and forth. But go further than you've ever ventured before. So put your hand over the top. When you do that at the end of a set, everyone's like, what's this crazy cyborg robot thing happening at the side of the stage? So, crazy harmonics, up the neck, the low E string, get that natural harmonic on the go. And go all the way to the bridge pickup. Again, you've got to have the bridge pickup engaged to get the most out of it, because if you go past the neck pickup, you won't get anything, you won't hear anything. So bridge pickup only for that one. So I've mentioned Herman Lee, I've mentioned Eddie Van Halen and Steve Vai. Now it's time to talk about Gojira, one of the best metal bands on the planet, in my humble opinion, with some epic riffs. And they make some quirky noises with their guitars. Everyone knows, like Stranded, it has the whammy effect in, so it goes up two octaves or an octave for the main riff, but they do a lot of this. That kind of chewy rake, like people do the rake all the time, kind of like the Steve Ray Vaughan. But when it's kind of the chewy, muted, and all that is simply using the side of your pick, similar to the PAC-MAN noise, but with the plastic guitar pick, and gently scraping up. Actually, you'd be pretty aggressive with it, while muting the strings with your left hand. And you get that chewy kind of... It's a hard thing to explain. What word is that? Besides the Gojira noise. They also use a lot of open strings just for the crack, like... It's a lot more musical when they do, but that's how you get the Gojira noises. I see when they do it live as well, they kind of move their hand down, like... Which gives you a bit more of a... sliding sound, I guess. But it's the same as doing it down there. And that's how you do the Gojira noise. Right, let's get back to using the good old trusty Floyd Rose system. Next up we have the elephant sound, or sometimes referred to as the whale sound, created by his lord and savior, Eddie Van Halen. Back in the day, there's a really cool video of him backstage playing this for a dude with a camera. And essentially, make your guitar sound like an elephant by hitting the fifth fret harmonic, the same as that like lower fifth fret harmonic on the G string, seventh fret harmonic on the B string. So that's quite a dissonant thing anyways. And top it off by hitting the 12th fret harmonic on the high E string. But that's not all. You have to do it when the volume of your guitar is down and the whammy bar is also down. So, check this out. So you've kind of got to go a bit cross-handy. Go under the guitar and reach the whammy bar so you can roll up the volume. At the same time, you're raising the pitch with the Floyd Rose and then back down again and roll the volume down. Couple more times. Goodness knows what people are thinking. It's kind of a hard thing to nail if you're in the middle of a solo, but as a little party trick to blow people's minds, the elephant is definitely one of the go-tos. It's a bit fiddly to do, but once you get the hang of it, and once you absolutely nail it, it puts a smile on your face and everyone that's around you. Only two more left to go. I'm getting to the end. I should have thought of more. I'm having all the fun in the world recording this video. I don't know what the name of this one is, but I saw Paul Gilbert do it years ago. And when you slide up, I'm using the G string, for example. When you slide up the string, obviously it goes up in pitch. But the thing with this noise is drop the bar, like lowering the pitch with your tremolo system. And try and keep that same note. So when you're going up in pitch, up the neck, lower the pitch with the trem system to get a really, really weird noise, and it's quite hard to do. I'm just gonna keep doing that until someone slams on that door. What would you call that? What's the name of that stupid noise? It's fantastic, but it's ridiculous. And last but certainly not least, we have how to make your guitar sound like a motorcycle. I am a ridiculously big Motley Crue fan. Mick Mars is one of my all-time idols. And that intro to Kickstart My Heart is just iconic. Making that guitar sound like a motorbike, changing up the gears as you're going down the strings, is legendary. We all know this song, but the thing I'm trying to get across is that is a motorbike revving the engine and changing up the gears. It's just a bit of fun. I couldn't not do this video without mentioning that iconic intro and one of the probably the most recognizable noises. Those are seven awesomely weird noises you can make on your electric guitar at home. And like I said at the start, comment down below if you want to expand on anything or add any quirky noises. Now for a couple of honourable mentions, I actually need a guitar without a locking tremolo. Two ticks. Bending the string behind the nut of the guitar is a lot of fun to do, and it makes your guitar sound like it's got a tremolo even when it hasn't. Think the start of Iron Man by Black Sabbath. Iommi bends behind the nut on that low E to get the intro sound. But not only that, you can do faux dive bombs. So hit a harmonic, say, again, fifth fret of the G string. They're a lot of fun to do. They're very simple. They're not the wackiest sound in the world, but I really wanted to include it on this list. Do be wary of snapping strings, though, or pulling the string out of the nut itself. So kind of gauge it. Don't just go all balls out and start hammering away your strings behind the nut, because the string might snap, or you might pull the string out completely. Be gentle with it, learn the tension, and dive bomb till your heart's content, until you get a guitar with a tremolo on. Now to end, it's another thing which isn't very useful, but it's really cool. I saw Phil X do this years and years ago, and technology has advanced, so there's more interesting things to use. I'll just explain it. So on your phone, you can get apps, right? Let's go to this close-up camera. Like Moog, do this app. And it's a Model D synth. It's really cool. And guitar pickups do pick up more things than just the strings. So if you were to... How cool is that? If that doesn't turn heads at your gig, I don't know what will. I've been doing that for ages. This is probably gonna get cut out. I've been doing this for ages. It's a lot of fun. And even like with that, you can play music through your pickups. Paul Gilbert actually screams into his pickups at the end of Get Out of My Yard. So you can, if you can scream loud enough, scream into your pickups and stuff comes through. But if I were to go, or even use this guy. This is getting ridiculous now, so I'm going to let you get on with your lovely day. That's been some weird and wonderful guitar sounds you can make with your bare hands. Whether you've got a Floyd Rose, whether you haven't got a Floyd Rose, hopefully there's been something in this video that tickles your pickle and you have all the fun in the world with it and share amongst your friends. And again, comment down below if you want to add anything, because I want more wacky sounds to add to my repertoire. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information or to check out any of the guitars I've spoke about in this video, I'll link them in the description box down below. Get yourself to PMTonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time. It's really tame now, isn't it?